Wrap up the holidays with the perfect gift. Give them what they want. The movie of the decade.
Who's this guy?
The smash hit of the season.
I'm Batman.
Can somebody tell me what kind of world we live in where a man dressed up as a bat gets all of my press?
Batman on video cassette. The gift you want to give. The gift they want to get. Specially priced at stores everywhere.
Tim Burton's 1989 film Batman stands as a significant milestone in the superhero genre and a testament to the director's unique vision. With its dark and brooding atmosphere, iconic performances, and gothic visual style, the film marked a departure from the traditional portrayal of the Caped Crusader, capturing the essence of the character's psychological complexities. Hi, I'm Arachnid. And in this video, I'm going to be aiming to explore the various aspects of Burton's Batman, including its thematic depth, cinematic techniques, and its lasting impact on the superhero genre. Burton's Batman showcases his visually signature gothic visual style, which is vividly brought to life in the film's art direction, production design, and cinematography. The dark and gloomy atmosphere of Gotham City, with its towering gothic architecture and perpetual night, establishes a sense of brooding tension and unease. Burton's use of shadows and high contrast lighting techniques enhances the film's noir sensibilities and emphasizes the duality of Batman's character. The gothic aesthetic serves not only as a visual spectacle, but it also reflects the psychological depths of the characters, particularly Batman's internal struggle with his alter ego, Bruce Wayne. The success of Batman can be attributed, in large part, to the exceptional performances of its cast. Michael Keaton's portrayal of the Dark Knight is a revelation, infusing the character with a sense of tormented introspection and restrained intensity. Keaton's ability to convey Batman's internal conflicts and the burden of his crusade against crime adds depth and complexities to the character, elevating him beyond a mere comic book superhero.
Then he had a...
Jack Nicholson's performance as the Joker is equally captivating. Nicholson brings a manic energy and twisted sense of humour to the role, making the character both terrifying and charismatic. His interpretation of the Joker remains one of the most memorable and iconic in cinematic history. The dynamic between Batman and the Joker forms the film's core conflict, as their contrasting ideologies and psychological makeup clash in a battle for Gotham's soul.
My balloons. Those are my balloons.
He stole my balloons! Why didn't somebody tell me that he had one of those things?
Hello. Gotham Corner Store? Yes, we seem to be down to our last diet cook. A gentleman is on his way to pick some up. Just look for a black car. No, this black car will be rather difficult to miss. And by the way, the gentleman is usually in quite a rush.
Just for the taste of it, Diet Coke!
Burton's Batman delves into several thought-provoking themes and subtext that transcend the superhero genre. The film explores the nature of identity and duality through the personas of Batman and Bruce Wayne. It delves into the psychological toll of vigilantism and the sacrifices one must make to protect others. Additionally, the film tackles the corrupting influence of power and the fine line that separates heroes from villains. The portrayal of Gotham City as a decaying urban landscape reflects social decay and urban alienation, echoing the anxieties of the late 1980s. The film subtly critiques the societal structures that breed crime and corruption, challenging the audience to question the role of individuals and institutions in shaping a just society. Burton's Batman left an indelible mark on the superhero genre, influencing subsequent adaptations of the character and shaping the way audiences perceive Batman. The film's success paved the way for a darker and more psychologically complex approach to superhero storytelling, setting a new standard for future adaptations. It demonstrated that superhero films could be more than mere popcorn entertainment, capable of exploring complex themes and engaging with audiences on a deeper level.
Hold it! Hold it right there! Let's see if you're really ready to watch this movie. Okay, popcorn? Check. Soft drink? Check. Warner Brothers ball cap? Aha! You can't watch a Warner Brothers movie without a Warner Brothers ball cap.
Listen, Doc, what if they ordered a Warner Brothers ball cap so they had it next time?
Well,
here's all you have to do, folks. Just send for this.
A new Warner Brothers catalog.
Use it to order your Warner Brothers ball cap. And while you're at it, you can order stuff like t-shirts, posters, movie books, ties. That's neckties.
It's all in the catalog, which you can get now by dialing this 900 number.
So when you get a chance, call...
No, they have to call now. They can't watch the movie until they order their new catalog.
You're despicable. Don't forget to call, folks.
Tim Burton's Batman remains a seminal work in the superhero genre, a dark and gothic masterpiece that challenges conventions and explores the depth of its characters' psyches. Through stunning visuals, exceptional performances, and thought-provoking themes, the film transcends its comic origins and becomes a compelling exploration of identity, power, and the human condition. Burton's gothic aesthetic and unique cinematic style create a visually stunning and immersive experience. Performances are nothing short of exceptional, with Keaton and Nicholson delivering iconic portrayals of their characters. Beyond its visual and performance prowess, Batman explores profound themes and subtext that elevate it beyond the realm of traditional superhero storytelling. The film delves in the nature of identity and the masks we wear in society. Batman's alter ego, Bruce Wayne, represents the facade of a wealthy playboy, while his true self, Batman, is a symbol of justice and vengeance. Bruce Wayne is the mask. This exploration of duality raises questions about the masks we all wear in our daily lives and the internal struggles we face to reconcile our various identities. The impact and legacy of Batman are undeniable. The film's success not only revitalized the Batman franchise, but it also paved the way for a new era of superhero films. Its dark and psychologically complex approach to the genre shattered preconceived notions of what a superhero film could be, opening doors for future adaptations to explore deeper themes and engage with audiences on a more profound level. The film's influence can be seen in subsequent Batman films, as well as in the wider superhero genre, which has embraced a more mature and nuanced storytelling approach. In conclusion, Tim Burton's 1989 film is a gothic masterpiece that transcends the boundaries of the superhero genre. With its visually stunning gothic aesthetic, exceptional performances and thought-provoking themes, the film remains a landmark in cinematic history. Burton's unique cinematic style and attention to detail create a visually immersive experience, capturing the dark and brooding essence of Gotham City. And how can I not talk about Danny Elfman's score? To this day, the soundtrack for Batman 1989 is one of my favourite movie soundtracks of all time. It is brilliant, with tracks like The Batman Theme, Descent into Mystery, Batman to the Rescue, The Joker's Waltz, The Batcave, Attack of the Batwing, and Finale. This soundtrack is brilliant. Danny Elfman is truly something else, and through this film we clearly see that his score is just unforgettable. We've also got music from Prince in this theme. He released an entire album from this film, My two favourite tracks from that album, Party Man, which is featured in the museum scene. You know, Lawrence and all that. And Trust also, which plays during the Joker's parade scene. Really, really good. Tim Burton's Batman stands as a testament to the power of visionary filmmaking. Its gothic aesthetic, exceptional performances and thematic depth make it a timeless classic that continues to captivate audiences and inspire filmmakers to this very day. This film's exploration of identity, morality and the human condition resonates beyond the realm of superheroes, making it a work of art that transcends its genre and holds a place of significance in the history of cinema. And I just want to briefly talk about my connection to this film. I think when I was, I want to say, 6 or 7 years old, I walked into my dad's room and he was watching a DVD on the TV. And I walk in, I look at it and go, "Ooh, what are you watching, Dad?" And he said, "Oh, I'm watching Batman." And then he was only about 10 minutes in, so he restarted the movie and said, "Sit down, watch it." Bearing in mind, in the UK, this film is rated a 15. And I was about 6 or 7, so But I sat down and watched it, and it truly was a revolutionary experience. That is one memory I will never forget, because Batman 89 introduced me to the world of Batman, to what superhero films could be when visionary directors like Tim Burton are put in charge. Like, obviously, as a kid, I didn't get a lot of the subtleties, a lot of the strokes of excellence in this film as a kid. But now, I look back at this movie, I look back at my first time watching it, and I think, how lucky was I to be able to experience this film at such a young age, to have a memory like that? And yeah, so for that reason, Batman 89 will always be one of my favourite superhero films. While I think Batman Returns is a better movie, Batman 89 holds a special place in my heart, and I am so excited to see Michael Keaton come back this June as the Caped Crusader. So, there we have it, guys. Thank you for watching this critical appreciation of Tim Burton's Batman. Please, if you enjoyed this video, make sure to like and subscribe, and drop a comment in the section below to tell me what you think of this movie. You know, do you love Keaton's Batman as well? Let me know what you think. But again, thank you for watching, and stay tuned for future videos. Stay safe out there, guys. Peace out.